I have to log in. I don't remember my password. I don't have time for this. This is the fifth time I've logged in. Oh, I'll be back. Hey, it's Dee Dee from Healthy Hearing Loss. I couldn't connect to my stethoscope last week. What did I do about it? And how can I prevent it from happening again in the future? That is what I'm going to talk about today in this video. So stick around. I have tried so many different stethoscopes during my working years in healthcare, and I have two stethoscopes that I use for two different reasons. And I'm going to show you what I use right now. And the first setup I have is for clinic use. I use this in the clinic. It is the Lippmann Core Digital Stethoscope. It's a pretty nice stethoscope, and I pair it with my Phonak Adeo. So I have one set of hearing aids to use with the Core, and then I stream it through my phone, through Bluetooth, to connect to an app called the Echo app. So I do that. It's the Core directly to my Phonak Adeo, and then it goes through Bluetooth to my phone, through the app, the Echo app, and then it goes, obviously, back to the stethoscope. That's setup number one. I use it in the clinic because it takes a little time to connect the things, and I have time to do that in the clinic. It's a little cumbersome, but it works for me, and I like it, and it's a little bit quieter in the clinic as well, and I just find that I like this stethoscope in the clinic. Sometimes I'll use it in the field, but it's rare. I usually use it only in the clinic. My second setup is the one I use from when I'm in the field. Again, I have to use a different stethoscope for this one, and this is the Thinklabs stethoscope. Thinklabs stethoscope is pretty nice. I really like it, and I pair it with my Phonak Cross 2, which is a different set of hearing aids, and this has T-coil. And then from my hearing aid, I use Phonak Compilot 2 to stream right through the T-coil. And this is the Compilot 2 that I use, and I just hang that around my neck. I connect it to an audio cable right from here, right to the stethoscope. So that's the triangle for setup number 2. Thinklabs stethoscope going to my Phonak Cross 2, over to my Phonak Compilot, through an audio cord to my stethoscope, through T-coil. And I use that out in the field because it's quick. It's hanging around my neck, and all I have to do is switch on my streamer, switch on my stethoscope, and I'm done. I don't have to do any pairing to the phone or worry about Bluetooth. That's really good for my hearing in the noisy environments outside. I was trying to connect to my Core stethoscope last week at work, but then I realized I had recently upgraded to a different phone. I used the Apple iPhone. I was using the 6 before. It was working perfectly. It was working great. And then I had the idea that I wanted to upgrade to the iPhone 12 Pro. Yeah, I think it's the iPhone Pro. What is this? Is this a Pro? It's the 12. And I wanted it because I wanted the camera. The camera takes fantastic pictures and video. The quality is outstanding. And I really wanted to upgrade my phone in that aspect. But when I got it, it works great. I'm connected to the internet. I can make phone calls. I can do whatever I need to do. And I go off to work. And when I went to go see a patient, it is like this. I'm ready to use it. I'm going to turn this on, go to my Echo app, and I have to log in. I don't remember my password. Oh, I'm sorry. I have to like figure this out. I don't have time for this. This is the fifth time I've logged in. Oh! All right. I got to go get my other... I'll be back. And then I went home, and of course I had to spend another 15 minutes trying to figure out how to log on to the Echo with my Core stethoscope. And basically it was giving me a hard time, and I just deleted it. Boop! And I had to reinstall it, and then I figured out my password, and I was able to connect to these two again, thankfully. Frustrating. But if you think about all of that, the time I had with the patient, and then trying to do the setup when I got home to try to log into the thing, the Echo thing, so that was 15 minutes, 20 minutes that I lost with my patient. It was very sad. With that being said, I have 5 tips for you guys. So number 1 is to make sure that you can pair your stethoscope to whatever you're pairing it to. If it's going to be the iPhone with an app, make sure that you can actually log in. That's probably number 1. And finding the right stethoscope that works for you, obviously, pair to the right one. Number 2 is to have a backup. I was able to go back to my other setup so that I didn't have to worry about that and I could still listen to my patients. Bodily sounds, but you need to have a backup, have a backup, have a backup. It's important. Number 3 is charging all of your devices and making sure that you charge them like 4 so that your battery doesn't die when you get to work. Just get in a routine of charging. That's what I do when I try to. If I'm really tired, I forget. Not a good thing to do. Number 4, always learn about the newest technology. There's so much technology out there. However, there's a caveat when there's new technology, like me getting a new phone. I didn't really need this phone. My other phone was working perfectly fine and I just caused an issue because I wanted the camera. Okay, I have a perfectly good camera in front of me. I don't need another camera, but I wanted it. So it's important to learn about the newest technology out there so that you can try different things and maybe something will work better for you out there. And then finally, number 5, I'm gonna say get a case for all your stuff. Get a case for all your stuff, all the stuff that you use, all your devices for your stethoscope, whether it's the streamer, the little cases that you use for your hearing aids that you put in here, and then maybe your other stethoscope that you put in there, maybe your streamer that you put in there. And of course, do you think I can fit the stethoscope in here? I don't think so. I think I need a bigger case. Whatever. Find a case that carries everything in one place so you don't lose it. Bonus, really a bonus. Patience. We have to have patience when we're learning about the different devices and technology equipment out there that we can use to better hear with our ears so we can take the best care of our patients. So patience. Deep breath. Meditate. Pray. Whatever you want to do, have some patience. Okay, I have to go to work. If you like this content, go ahead and hit the like button, subscribe, and hit the little notification, and I shall see you later. Bye.